Republican Senator Marco Rubio continues to prove me correct when I claim that he is the dumbest person in the United States Senate. And he did a wonderful bang-up job of it this week when he tweeted out that the $3.5 trillion reconciliation bill wasn't socialism. It was, in fact, Marxism. Oh, now we've moved on from the socialism boogeyman to the Marxism boogeyman. And Marxism sounds even scarier than communism because most people have no idea what it means. But they see the word Marx at the beginning of it and they assume it's some kind of like super communism, which I think is what Marco Rubio was trying to get at. Luckily, he was schooled on social media by Nobel Prize winning economist Paul Krugman. Krugman said this in response. Ah, yes. Remember that stirring line in the Communist Manifesto? Workers of the world, unite to spend 1.2% of GDP on popular programs over the next decade. Small, right? It's not exactly the kind of burn we're used to on Twitter, but it did mock Marco Rubio, and it provided facts, and it was only two sentences long. You know, I don't always agree with Krugman on everything, but the dude is smart. You gotta give him that. And he really did, you know, kind of shut Rubio down. And of course, everybody else on social media, too, was ribbing Rubio over being so incredibly stupid. But here's the thing. Rubio wasn't just being dumb. Rubio was playing to a strategy. And that strategy is use words that my base thinks are scary, but they don't really know what they mean. Now, the definition of Marxism, in fact, there is no single definition of Marxism. It is, in fact, a theory, and it's a theory that's evolved over the years, and it's a theory that has branched off into multiple different things. So there's no singular idea anymore of what Marxism really is. But most of it is rooted in a class struggle between the haves and the have-nots. You know, that's really oversimplifying it. But, you know, that's kind of what's at the heart of a lot of it. That's nothing like what this $3.5 trillion over 10 years reconciliation bill is. This is a piece of legislation spending roughly $350 billion a year to help struggling Americans and, of course, to revamp our energy grid, to get us moving to clean energy, to provide universal childcare, to expand Medicare here in the United States, to literally take care of the people who have been denied the means to take care of themselves. That's what this piece of legislation is. I mean, if anything, Marco Rubio, you should understand, you tweet out Bible quotes all the time. This is what Jesus would do. I know nobody wears those little WWJD bracelets anymore, but maybe you should, because what would Jesus do? Jesus would do the Build Back Better Act. That's what would happen here. But no. You'd rather confuse your base, you'd rather use words that they don't understand, and that can't be easily looked up, by the way. You know, you can't just hop on Wikipedia for 5 seconds and understand what Marxism is. You really probably could with, you know, communism and socialism, so they have to one-up it. But everything they don't like is some kind of communism. Marjorie Taylor Greene is called the Green New Deal. Communism. We have seen Republicans. This is communism, communism, Marxism now. They don't even know what these words mean. And honestly, I want reporters to start asking them those questions. Next time somebody is in front of Marco Rubio and you have a camera, I want you to ask him and I want you to film it. What does Marxism mean, Mr. Rubio? You tweeted out that the Build Back Better Act was Marxism. Tell us what Marxism is. Tell us what communism is. Tell us what any of these words that you and your colleagues use every day, tell us what they mean. And watch them scramble. And not just Rubio either. Do it to Ted Cruz. Do it to Marjorie Taylor Greene. Do it to any one of these idiot Republicans that throws these words around just to scare their base, even though neither they nor the base has any clue what they actually mean. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel for fresh content 7 days a week.